Hey people, my name is Gerben and I'm a seller and collector of vintage computers for over 16 years now. I've been selling on eBay all over the world, and today we're going to unpack some new computers that came. Now, well, not new, of course, they're all old. Some computers that came in the mail, and let's have a look what we've got. Okay, the next item is also MSX related. This is very funny because the guy who sold it had in the title of the description, he said computer. Only, it said only computer. So I saw the picture and I think I have to have this because it's very... most of the times it's very expensive. This time it was very cheap because of the title, I think. So let's see what we got. Okay, this is the small package that came, and it was sold as computer. Let's hope there is not a computer inside but something else. Let's have a look. This is very nice. I sold several of these. It's the MSX music module, and you can connect it to your MSX machine and make some music with it. You also can connect a full size keyboard, and let's have a look. The box is very in very good condition, as you can see. Let's see what's inside. I hope it's all complete because there's lots of stuff that goes with it. This is the module itself. It has MIDI, some other connections. Here you can connect the original Philips keyboard. Very nice. I think that's all that's included. But that's not a problem. Very nice. You've got everything in the test situation. The module is plugged in. It's big, as you can see. It's in MSX2. And we will turn it on and see what happens. You can select another song by pressing first on the stop, then on the music selection, and hold down the space bar while you are flipping right or left, and then you're going to playback again and press the space bar again. Okay, very nice, very cool, very blinky, I think. And you can follow the rhythm with the caps lock blinking. Next item is also MSX related, and if you are wondering why so many MSX stuff, because it's a really good seller. There's lots of people in the world, especially in Spain, and Italy is also very enthusiastic, that want to buy MSX stuff. And I had the opportunity to buy a part of a computer, and let's see what we've got. This is the package that came. Not too much protection, I think. I hope everything is okay, but I think it will be. Let's have a look. It's a keyboard for the Philips NMS 8250 or the 55 or even the 80. It looks very good, and lots of machines are missing the keyboard, so it's always very handy to have some keyboards extra. And somebody sends some more clothes. I think I have a whole wardrobe full of clothes by now. If I see how many people use clothes to protect their sendings. It's not really very hygienic, but it's protective, I think. Next machine is a small laptop. I was told it's got a broken hinge and it's maybe not really good. But it's working, and it was not very expensive, so let's have a try, shall we? Okay, nice small box. It's not Amazon, no, it's not Amazon, but feels good. Let's have a look. Power supply. Okay, it's a very small machine. It's a high screen 386 SX25. It's well on the low end of the laptops. Let's see what's inside. Open up. Come on. It's very nice. Very nice form factor and very small. The hinge is not very nice, and there's a big hole in the where the battery has to go. Let's have a closer look. Well, here's the machine up close and personal. I've hooked it up to the power. I'm not sure if you can see it, but the light is on. And let's see what we can do with this machine. Well, the beeper is working. And so on and so on. Okay. Well, it beeps. That's one thing for sure. I think this machine needs a little bit more attention. Can you see something happening here? No.
Okay, I think this is all we can get.
Next up is another classic machine, a classic portable machine, I have to say. It's from the CPM family, and I like these computers very much because they're very old, but most of the times they work very nice. And let's see what we've got this time. As you can see, we have a big box. These portable machines, or I have to say portable, were more like transportable because people would lug these things everywhere and will be very, you don't have to go to the gym because this is enough exercise, I think. Enough talk, let's see what's inside the box. Right, can you guess what it is? It's gray, but that doesn't help you. Let's see. It's a Bondwell 12. Oy. And this is one of the early CPM machines. I think the outside looks very good. Let's have a better look. Here we have a better look at the Bondwell 12 CPM machine. Let's see what we got on the inside. Oh, this looks very good. Also with some floppies. It's always good to put some floppies in there for transport, but you have to close them, of course, because otherwise the heads of the floppy drives will still bounce away. I think it will be okay. Some more floppy, some inlays for the keyboard. I think it's a nice machine. This is from one of the discs I make and I sell on eBay. This is very funny. Have you ever seen Zork on a Bondwell? This is very high tech. Yes, very nice.
CPU 4 MHz. very storage. User M. Maximum 128 kilobytes dynamic RAM. RAM. 4 kilobytes solid RAM. Video RAM. 2 kilobytes static RAM.
And so on, and so on.
Secondary storage.
Very cool.
2.5 quarter inches mini floppy disk drive.
A computer from 1983 with speech synthesizer. Was very uncommon in these days.
40 tracks per side. Soft sector. Double density.
Okay, next computer is something that was brought to my home today. By a very nice gentleman. And of course we had to have the little retro talk about what this computer meant to him when he was a small boy. This computer was bought, not exactly this computer, but one of the colleagues of his father bought this computer through a program in Holland that's called PC Privé. It means that you can buy a computer in the 80s, 90s, whatever, and it's tax-free. So it's nice for you to buy a computer that's more cheap. And I think your employer also really likes the idea because it was a way for people to get to know a computer for the first time. For the first time there were computers available for the public, and everybody bought a PC Privé, and lots of people were very happy with it, and lots of people just tried it one time they tried it, it worked, they didn't understand it, and it went into the cupboard. And it sat there for 20, 30 years, and along comes this guy and he buys these computers, and they're very good because they are not, they don't have many working hours. And there's also kinds of, there's the more the PC like, but also a lot of home computers that were bought and that were part of the PC Privé projects. Anyway, let's see what we got. I know that the guy told me that the hard drive is broken, so don't expect that to work. But we will see what we've got and we will see if it works.
And there you have it. It's a nice laser computer. It's XT380086. And I think Laser is a very well-known brand in the Netherlands. It's complete with the branded keyboard, the computer and the monitor. It's all hooked up, and let's see how this baby goes. There's a big nice switch again. Oh, and we have to connect power first, of course, and now again. Look at this, a nice red display. Oh, the monitor needs some additional tinkering, I think. Oh, here we go. Seems like the pot meter of the monitor is not completely happy. So, oh, okay. Don't touch it anymore, because now it works. Drive 1 is not initialized. Run install routine for this drive. Yeah, well enough. Why not? Yes. Let's see. I was hoping it would boot from floppy, but and here we have a little sneak peek what is inside of this computer. The normal usual cards, I think. Something funny is of course this transition piece from the big floppy to the small floppy, and also some additional plastic to make it all fit. Here is the disk, the hard drive, and here we have the nice front thingy. And something peculiar, here is the mouse that was delivered with the computer. But there are supposed to be these connectors for the mouse, but there are not. So, where do we put this mouse? Anyway, it looks nice and clean inside. Unfortunately, I did not get it to boot. I think there's a problem with the disk drive, because the disk drive is always spinning, or the light is always on, but I can hear that it's trying really bad, but it's not working. I really love this display. This display, this is really nice. I never saw something like this. The reset button is not working, and it's a nice and complete set with everything there. Very nice. We come to the end of the video. I hope you liked it. I liked it a lot. I really enjoy making these videos. I hope to see you next time. Please like and subscribe, because that really, really helps. And leave a comment below if you have any questions or remarks or anything. And I hope to see all of you next time. Bye bye.